Hello, Daphne here with another video for you. This is titled Out the Window. Over the years, traveling worldwide, one of the things that I have enjoyed doing was looking at the landscape and what was going by as we were riding either on a road or a dirt road or in a safari vehicle to wherever we were going. It's been amazing what some of these roadside images have captured. It's given me a lot of insight into the people of the country, their dress, their way of life, their commerce, whatever. And I have had the most wonderful time and created some very memorable images when I have kept my eyes open for the scenery and the action as I pass by. Now, this series of photos was taken in Tanzania. We had landed in Manyara Airport, M-A-N-Y-A-R-A, and we were headed for the Ngorongoro Crater. That is about a two-hour drive. And to amuse myself along the way, I had my trusty camera aimed out the window, and the following are some of the photographs that I snapped on that day, and there are some really interesting ones that provide an insight into the people of Tanzania and a little bit about their daily lives. So here is an overloaded bicycle going down the side of the road. Oh, there are some wonderful images, I promise you. Whoops. Next, we have this darling little boy, most likely going somewhere to fetch water for his family. We saw this scene very often of kids holding these plastic buckets in order to bring refreshing water back to their family home. This is a very dynamic picture of these two women running down the side of the road. Of course, one of the things that's absolutely fascinating in a lot of these African countries is the very colorful dress. And here's an example of that. And here's a woman that's all decked out with a scarf around her neck and a red top. And this, she looks determined. Wherever she's going, she's got a mission on her mind. Oh, look at these three little adorable kids holding hands, just walking down the side of the road. And I guess they saw our car coming by because they looked at me just as I snapped this picture. Here is a young, I guess it's a girl, with a stack of kindling wood strapped to her back. I don't know, this was sort of a haunting image to me for some reason. I was endlessly amazed at the amount of goods that these Tanzanians put on the back of bicycles. I mean, it was incredible how they balanced them and rode. Don't ask me how, but there were numerous images like this all along the way, and I couldn't believe it. Whoops, here we have a little accident by the side of the road. I don't know whether all that hay was coming undone or what, but obviously repairs were in order as they parked the vehicle there to find out what the problem was. This is just a wonderful picture of, look at all the different colors in those fabrics. They like putting pink and red together, all the bright colors. And this scarf even has the name of a company written on the bottom, across the bottom. But I love the way they mix and match. Oh, here was a wonderful scene of a couple of ox carrying a cart with a Tanzanian boy on the back, and then a herd of cattle on the left there as we come up over a crest of a hill. I really like this picture. And here's a close-up of that same picture. What a lovely image this is of a mother and her three children walking somewhere, who knows where, but they're so nicely dressed. Look at that white jacket with a little gray stripe, and the mother's hand gently making sure her baby is resting comfortably on her back, and the little white shoes. I don't know, there's something adorable about this picture. And the little boy carrying a pink bag, a satchel with who knows what inside. Here are a group of Tanzanian men. So many of them walk around with walking sticks, and they're just draped in these different colored printed or plaid fabrics. You saw them all over the place. Many of the Maasai wore that red plaid that I saw in other parts of Kenya, for example. And notice the beaded anklets on their ankles. Those are all the designs are interesting. And some of the beadwork in these African countries is exquisite. Here are two women in colorful and interesting outfits. Oh, I just love the prints and the way they mix everything up. They don't really have any desire to match. They just like to combine solids and prints and stripes and everything else. But here are two women having a conversation as we pass them by. I like the dynamics of this picture. That is a beautiful outfit. And I like this little girl that is pictured on the bottom of what looks to be a satchel she's carrying. Oh, next we saw so many young children with on the side of the road, pushing bicycles or riding bicycles with goods on the back. Or here's a case of a young boy. It looks like he's got a tank full of something, and these oxen are carrying him to his destination. Oh, I think this is a great picture. Really shows just an everyday scene on the side of the road, but a lovely one. And look at that bright colored soil. This picture just tickles me no end. I don't know what she's counting up on her fingers, but she looks very intense. And all at the same time, carrying a heavy load on the top of her head. We saw so many women carrying these heavy baskets of goods on the top of their head. This one looks like she's got a basket full of lettuce leaves or greens of some kind. Now, heaven only knows what, how and when they'll ever make it to their destination with this load of, gosh, I don't even know what that is. But apparently it must be valuable to somebody, because those two workers are trying to travel down the road with a big, huge load. And I would think that any slight amount of wind might blow their treasured cargo away. Here's just another picture of roadside people in colorful outfits. And look at these young kids driving in the road. Interesting, isn't it? And then over to the left here, two really, really young children all by themselves. We did not see a parent in sight when I took this picture. And I don't know what this woman was doing, but I got a kick out of her outfit. Very interesting. And look at those socks with the stripes and patterns on them. And I guess she's collecting things that are discarded on the side of the road. I'm not sure. But her clothes are sure pretty, aren't they? And here's a boy, sheep herder. We saw many scenes like this on our way to the Ngorongoro Crater. Or Ngorongoro Crater. I can never pronounce that right, so forgive me. And don't you love this picture with these two barrels on either side, balanced perfectly? And look at the, I don't know if that's hair coming out of that helmet or a fur trim, but it's an interesting photo, don't you think? And he's got Tanzania written all over that red shirt. Now here's a lady with a colorful outfit on, but I guess a little bit grumpy at the moment that picture was shot. Here's another family walking down the road. Oh, don't you just love these outfits, the colors, the prints? I mean, they had a style all their own, and they either, here they're all, they all have shoes on, but oftentimes many of them were wearing just flip-flops. But these people look like they're deep in conversation. A pregnant lady and her companion and a little person behind them. And I love the expressions on the pregnant lady's face. Looks very inquisitive, and the other lady looks very, very serene and content. Another family walking down the road. Where they're going, only heaven knows. But aren't they amazing? Aren't their costumes amazing? Well, these two young kids are struggling up this hill with two barrels. It must be filled with something very heavy because obviously they couldn't continue riding the bike. So nothing like pushing it instead of riding. And here we have two men and their calf, taking that calf somewhere. And I just love pictures like this. I mean, there were so many pictures of people walking down the road with animals or carrying things or just being with families. It was just a wonderful panoply of images. Well, here's that. Here's another card, or is it the same one? I'm not sure. I think it's a different one. I have no idea what they're carrying. Looks like dead branches of trees to me. And look at this sweet little boy all by himself, just along the side of the road, walking somewhere in his flip-flops. I don't know, I like this image a lot. This was amusing. You can't even see this person's head from that huge hat of, I don't know, grass or weeds or whatever it was, but whatever it was, it obscured this image. I assume it's a man, but who knows? Here's another young boy herding a group of cattle somewhere. And this is the last picture This is a goat and cattle herder who looked around for some reason. I'm not sure why, but you can see that traveling down the road in Tanzania was a dusty experience, but we enjoyed every minute of it, and I had more fun capturing these images of everyday life at a moment in time in Tanzania. Now remember one last thing. Remember, the trip you don't take is the one you will always, always, always regret.